Good morning, children. Welcome back. We were learning lesson number 11, the United Nations, which is UN, and this is your second video. This is your page number 88. Let's continue with the Security Council. It is the most important organ of the UN. It has 15 members. Out of these 15 members, 5 countries, that is USA, Britain, France, Russia, and China, are the permanent members. The other 10 members are elected for a term of 2 years by the General Assembly. So, the most important organ of UN has 15 members. Out of these 15, 5 countries are the permanent members. They never resign or they are never excluded. The other 10 members are elected for the term of 2 years by the General Assembly. You understand? ये 5 member जैसे हमारे राज्यसभा में होते हैं, biannually elect होते हैं, इसी तरह यहाँ पे 5 members जो member countries हैं, they are always there. और बाकी के जो 10 countries हैं, they are elected for a term of 2 years by General Assembly. The Security Council enjoys tremendous powers to manage peace and security in the world. यही उनका काम है. That is why the UN was established so that they can manage the peace and security in whole of the world. Its aim is to solve disputes between nations diplomatically as long as possible. The head of the United Nations is known as the Secretary General. He is appointed by the General Assembly at the recommendation of the Security Council. So, head is Secretary General, and who appoints them? He is appointed by the General Assembly at the recommendation of the Security Council. He works as the Chief Administrative Officer of the UN. Now, how does the Security Council bring peace solution in case of dispute between 2 countries? This we have done in the last video's explanation, it was there. What is done by the Security Council in a situation when a quarrelsome nation disrespects the resolutions of the UN? This we can understand, you know, referring to the earlier video also in this paragraph. What are the functions of the Secretary General of the UN? Who is the recent Secretary General of UN? Who is the recent Secretary General? You can Google the answer. And what are the functions of the Secretary General of the UN? These functions are also, you know, whatever the main objectives are there of the UN, that can be stated. Now, what is veto? The veto power on right to deny is a negative vote casted against a proposal in the Security Council. It is necessary for all the 5 permanent members of the Security Council to agree over any decision. The resolution does not pass if any of the member uses veto. See, for example, जैसे हमारे कंट्री में होता है, हम बिल प्रपोज करते हैं, you know, लोकसभा में हमारे जो ministers होते हैं, वो बिल प्रपोज करते हैं. Then that bill goes to the Rajya Sabha. Then the Rajya Sabha signs that bill, approves that bill. Then it goes to the president for his consent. The bill becomes a law only after the president has signed the bill. Correct? This procedure we all know. Now, similar to that is the veto power or the right to deny. If any member from the 5 permanent members, हमने देखा था, there are 5 countries which are permanent members of the UN, right? अब इस UN के जो 5 countries हैं, उसमें से एक भी country ने अगर veto power use किया, that means कोई भी bill या कोई भी ऐसा law आया, agreement आया उनके पास, जो उनको नहीं पसंद या वो if they are not agreeing over that bill, they can use their veto right, and what will happen? The resolution will not pass. Resolution pass होने के लिए पांचों जो member countries हैं, permanent members हैं, उनको agree करवाना जरूरी है. Only then it can become a law for the entire UN, United Nations. Understood? So, it is necessary for all the 5 permanent members of the Security Council to agree over any decision. किसी ने भी disagree किया, the resolution does not pass if the 5 members, if any of the 5 members passes veto. Understood? Now, do you believe that the number of permanent members in the Security Council should be increased? Why? Why is it said that the post of the Secretary General of the United Nations carries a lot of responsibility? Always remember, any designation, any seat comes with a responsibility. As we have studied, rights and duties are two sides of the same coin. So if one is getting that designation, one is getting that rights, obviously he has to perform some duties, some responsibility he has to shoulder. And always this also has to be remembered that kingship is the crown of thorns. Whosoever gets any powers, you will never be able to satisfy everyone. It is the crown of thorns. Understood? Let's see the special organizations of the United Nations. The main objective of the United Nations is to foster economic, social, cultural and educational development of the people and help them in improving their standard of living by generating more employment opportunities. To achieve these objectives, various organizations have been established to work in specific areas under the leadership of the United Nations. So we have seen what is the main objective of the United Nations. It is to foster or to inculcate cultural and educational development of people, not only in their own country, but in all the member nations, and improving the standard of living by generating more employment opportunities. See, more number of employments will be there, people will be having more jobs, and more people will be having jobs, that means they can more people will be there who will be able to earn their basic living. To achieve these objectives, various organizations have been established to work in specific areas with the help of United Nations. Let's study these. Name of the special organization of the UN, which is World Health Organization. What is its short form? WHO. Where is the headquarters? Geneva. Major functions of the organization is to make it makes efforts to improve the physical and mental health of the people of the world. Nowadays, we have heard this name a lot, WHO. So this is World Health Organization and the headquarters is in Geneva. Next is United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, which is UNESCO. The headquarters is in Paris. What are the major functions? To contribute peace and security by promoting international collaboration through education, science and culture in order to further universal respect for justice, the rule of law and human rights. Next is International Labour Organization. Short form is ILO. Again, the headquarters is in Geneva. It promotes rights at work, encourages decent employment opportunities, enhances social protection and strengthens dialogue on work-related issues. So we can say it works for the betterment of the labor community, for the laborers. Next is United Nations International Children Emergency Fund. Now United Nations International Children's Fund, it is renamed. The short form is UNICEF and its headquarters is in New York. It works to provide long-term humanitarian and developmental assistance to children and mothers in the developing countries. That means the countries which are not very rich, to get good standard of living and nutritious food, and organize children welfare programs. So basically it works for the upliftment or betterment of the children in not so developed countries, jo countries bahut zyada rich nahi hain. Food and Agriculture Organization, FAO, headquarters Rome, to ensure that people get a regular supply of enough and high quality of food, also to promote agriculture. World Bank, which is International Bank of Reconstruction and Development. It works to provide low interest loans, interest-free credits and grants to the developing countries. These support a wide array of investments in such areas as education, health, public administration, infrastructure, financial and private sector development, agriculture and environmental and natural resource management. Headquarters is in Washington, D.C. and the short form is WB or IBRD, International Bank of Reconstruction and Development. So it provides low interest loans to all these sectors, all these different fields, so that they can come up to at par. Their country can progress a little bit. Understood? Now here an interesting activity is given. You have to identify the logo given below and write down its full name. Few names are already printed on the logo, as UNESCO, ILO, all these are already printed. others you have to search and write the names of the logos which are given, and there is space provided below that. You have to write down the names, whether it is World Bank, UNIDO, UNESCO, etc. Understood? Next is collect the logo of distinct organization of your city, village, taluka. Which organization logo symbols are given below? These are also different logos given. First one is of Olympic. Other two you have to find out. Now here they have given, prepare a report on the special organizations of the United Nations by collecting more information from reference books. Logo of the organization, full form, objective of the organization, headquarter, functions, etc. All this we have already learnt. Logo, it is already mentioned. Jiska naam tum log already likh chuke ho textbook mein, so no need of that. You have to write down the full form, that is also mentioned. Objective of the organization, that also we learnt in the table earlier. Headquarters and functions, same thing. Functions is equal to objectives, that is already written. Prepare a list of other organizations working at the international level. If you are aware of any of them, at least list two or three. Okay, let's proceed further with cooperation of India to UN. India has adopted the strategy of solving the disputes with other countries through UN. India has always contributed on a large scale to the peacekeeping forces of the United Nations by sending soldiers wherever required. So this has been India's strategy, or help to different other nations. It has always contributed on a large scale to keep peace, okay, by sending soldiers wherever required. India has sent a team of doctors to treat the wounded soldiers in Korean War. Indian delegates on various posts in the UN have contributed to the welfare with their knowledge and experience. India's contribution as a member of the Security Council and other organs has always been noteworthy. So it has been a quality of India or the Indians since ages, that we have always been on a peaceful side, on a non-violent side. So we sent our soldiers, we also sent our doctors to treat the wounded soldiers of the war in Korea. And other organs we have always been helping the Security Council and other organs. Now the great ideas of Panchsheel are a gift of India to the world. It were the ideas given to us by our Chacha Nehru, that is Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. So those ideals or objectives of the Panchsheel are a gift of India to the world. Now here you have to make a list of Indians who have rendered their services in various councils of the United Nations. As one we know, Vijayalakshmi Pandit, name of the council and position she held. Gather more information about the principles of Panchsheel with the help of your teacher or library and write it down. Presently you can take help from Google. Next is the ray of hope for human race. If all the countries of the world cooperate with the United Nations, world peace can be obtained in the real sense. As we have seen during the time of Britishers, what happened? They introduced the subsidiary alliance system, and the kings who followed the subsidiary alliance system, you remember what was the main thing in that? They will not make two countries or two territories fight with each other. Jab dono aaju baju ke territories ne, kings ne, agar subsidiary alliance adopt kiya, to they will not fight with each other. Britishers apne hi dono territory ke soldiers ko thodi na fight karvayenge. So if that principle, if we use today, if the people or if the nations do not fight with each other, instead they cooperate with the United Nations, definitely there will be peace prevailing throughout the world. For this, it is necessary that every country resolves to stop the production of deadly weapons. So first and foremost, the production of deadly weapons should be stopped. Crores of rupees can be saved if this race of increasing weapons in the countries end. This money can be used for the welfare of the people. Jitna paisa, weapons ke production mein lagaya jata hai, agar wo desh ki bhalai ke liye lagaya jaye, how much welfare it can do to the whole nation or whole of world on a whole. Earth is the only planet for us to live. Thus, human beings have to aim at achieving world peace and universal brotherhood. So this should be our aim, because Earth is the only planet. We cannot go and live on any other planet. So Earth is our home. So why not live with our neighboring nations as our own neighbors or as our own relatives and friends? World will be a very better place, a very good place to live, if we, all the people, including all the nations, you know, of the world, think in that way. Now your exercise is given. You have to refer the video as well as the textbook and solve these answers. Answer the following questions. State whether the following statements are true or false. That also you will be able to solve once you go through the videos of this chapter. Here, true or false is given. Then short notes are also given. We are all aware how to write the short notes. Okay. For each short note, you will write at least 8 points of 2 sentences each. Now here, find out the logo of the below mentioned organizations and either stick them or draw them in your notebook and write the full name of the organizations. UNICEF, this is no need to do. We have already done. Under the logos, we have already written the name. So this, it's okay, we avoid. Here, identify the logo given below of the organizations working at the international level and write down its full form. Okay, with the help of internet, you can check this. Make a list of sports played in Olympics. Draw the ground of any 2 games that are being played in your area. Do you write the rules of the games? You will write down 2 games which are played in the Olympics. No need to write in the fair book. Anywhere else, revision book, you can write down. Okay. Thank you, children. Stay home. Stay safe.